Hey, everybody, welcome back. Big topic today, CBD, with my very good friend, Ryan Christopher, who is at Cosmedix Skincare in gorgeous Atlanta, Georgia. How are you, Ryan?
It actually is gorgeous in Atlanta, Georgia right now because we're scooping into the fall season. So the humidity's coming down. The heat's finally coming down. I can stand outside right now and not break into a full body sweat.
You're telling me you're going to get like eight nice days and then it'll be back to Atlanta weather, right?
Correct. Yes. As we've all typically seen in different parts, you know, we see an extreme and then it goes back to whatever it's going to go to next. Good.
Well, I know we're going to talk CBD. I don't have any hemp plant pictures. This is as close as I could get were these big lily pads. So they're green though.
They're green. At least it's green. Yes.
Okay. So I know you're always training around the world. You're headed to the Ukraine and Germany and assorted other places. And then I'm going to catch up with you at ICSC in Fort Lauderdale. So I'm looking forward to that.
We've got a tight schedule coming up.
Oh my God. I have like six shows before I'm done for the year. So, you know, CBD, people keep saying to me, are cannabinoids, is this a trend? And I tell them, actually, it's not a trend. It's here to stay. There's no doubt in my mind that this is the next place we're going. It's going to get incorporated a lot of ways. So tell me what you guys are doing with CBD.
Well, as you said, it's an exciting ingredient. It is generating a lot of buzz because I truly believe because of the legalities around the plant that it comes from, right? So there has been a lot of interesting changes in our country over the years that are now bringing this hemp plant to life. And CBD is one of those exciting components. So where it was always the underground kind of talk about THC and what that cannabinoid does for our system, now it's all about the CBD and what that and how that actually affects it. So it's just a really interesting batch of information that's coming out. And there's a lot right now, unfortunately, at the beginning of any trend, there's a lot of hype around it. And I'm excited to see years of research come forward so that we can really see how we can use this plant extract to really benefit skin conditions.
Awesome. Okay, people don't know that hemp, THC, we're going to talk about the difference, but this has been going on since time immemorial, the beginning of man. It's amazing that people are sort of just catching up, but that's also the nature of our business as well. But you know how I know it's come full circle? Because my very dear friend George, our neighbors George and Carol, George has a bad shoulder. He asked me if I had any CBD or THC in all my skincare that I could, that he could have, that he could rub on his arthritis, and he's 85.
You know, it is now well known. People are looking for it, and they've heard the different benefits that it can have. So now it is more than available to consumers out there. And it's just important for me as a brand representative and educator that the information we're sharing is accurate, and that it is, we are educating both the professional spa person and the consumer with the correct information and that we're not overhyping this ingredient.
Wonderful. And I love that because, Ryan, you have always been an amazing straight shooter. So I think because you and I are always of the same mindset is why I love these conversations. And let's get to a few things I made notes on if we can.
Yeah.
Claims versus evidence. How does anyone figure that out?
Well, you know, there are many studies going on right now along CBD and how it affects both the body inside and outside. What's really interesting is that a lot of the confirmed studies are based around the medical approach first. So there are a lot of clinical studies that have been tested with this extract being either given orally or also injected into the system. And by getting these ingredients and following these clinical studies that show what this ingredient can do internally in the system, both in humans and animals, is very fascinating, but we have to always remember that those clinical studies do not relate directly to this ingredient being applied topically. There's a much bigger difference in clinical studies that show how an ingredient affects the skin when applied in a certain percentage. And unfortunately, there are not enough direct human studies that have been conclusive to show what this ingredient can fully do or fully affect our skin topically. Now, there have been a lot of great studies that have concluded how this ingredient can be effective medically. And what we have seen this year, which is very exciting, is that the FDA has approved one purified form of CBD that now is a prescription drug for the treatment of epilepsies and seizures. And so this is actually being prescribed, and it's absolutely fantastic. But topically, we're still not seeing a lot of conclusive human trials on how this ingredient is conclusive on affecting the skin, whether it is anti-inflammatory, whether it is actually affecting the sensory neurons to reduce pain and the look of redness in the skin. Now, those brief things that I just mentioned are actually things that have been seen and concluded in animal studies, haven't yet been completely concluded in human studies, but those are being done right now. We're just waiting to see that conclusive information.
Okay, so I wrote down the word common sense, but as Ben Franklin said, common sense is uncommon. Mm-hmm. I attended three trade shows that were concurrent in Las Vegas, and one of them had close to 300 or 400 CBD, vape, mine, even for a guy like me who's now been around it a lot longer because I spent half the year in California, but certainly in our market for a couple years, and it is mind-bending, Ryan. I want your answer to that, and then I know we got to go, and we're going to come back after a short break, and we'll do part two of CBD and look at a little bit of what you're doing. So answer me the common sense issue, please.
The common sense issue is that when you apply this ingredient to your skin, whether it's in a serum or a moisturizer, you're not curing cancer. You're not healing any diseases. This is still a very beneficial ingredient, but much like lavender essential oil, much like tea tree oil, much like so many other extracts that have been proven to have either antioxidant, anti-inflammatory, or antimicrobial properties, yes, those ingredients have been proven to have these abilities, but it's not the end-all be-all. It is another great ingredient, another awesome plant extract that does promise a lot of great benefits. But what you'll see and what I believe over time is that as the CBD craze and trend starts to die down, then we'll start to see brands circle back with truly meaningful formulations based around this ingredient with other active ingredients to really support the overall effect.
Okay, that's common sense right there. Yes. So I wrote down always what I think, you know, it goes right around with do no harm, right? The Hippocratic oath.
Do no harm, positive good.
Right? No claims. We just don't make claims in our business, plain and simple. So,
exactly. Right,
there's so much to talk about. We could do a 10-parter. Ryan and I will be back in just a minute. We're going to do part two. We're going to look at some products.
Fantastic.
Talk to you in a minute.